Hello, my beautiful friends. It's been so long that I haven't posted or like filmed any videos, but I have my reasons. I was busy with school stuff. I injured my ankle while it was, you know, carrying shitloads of things, and then I just like, you know, twisted my ankle while I was like, you know, just casually walking. So because I sprained my ankle, I was like literally in bed for like one whole week. And then after I rest for like a week in bed, like literally in bed, I didn't go anywhere. Like I just stay in bed, and then thank God like I have like my boyfriend like to help me with all the, you know, food and stuff. So I was literally eating and, you know, just staying in my bed. So after a week, I really need to get out. And then so we went out with my boyfriend's workmates. When we first went out, my ankle was not fully recovered, but then I can like still walk without the, you know, the clutches. So after that night, I start to like hurt again. Like when you put pressure on that feet, I just like stay home for like another day in bed. I just put that feet like to be like, you know, elevated. I didn't put any pressure. And then like after resting for one day, and then like I went out again with my boyfriend to like get some dinner. But before dinner, like I wanted to go do some shopping for some things that I need. So like we went there for a while, and then my boyfriend needs to have haircut. We have like salon appointment, so we can't miss it. So like we have to go back and forth. And after doing that, and then while we were eating dinner, like I can feel that my feet was like starting to like really hurt again. Like I can't put any pressure. Like even when I was like sitting and like I was just eating my dinner, like I can feel that, like I can put the feet flat on the ground because I think the blood is like flowing down, and then there is like a bit of a pressure. I was starting to like get really frustrated because like it should be fully recovered by now. It wasn't like a serious injury, but like it was just like minor thing. But then the reason is that it's starting to be really cold here in Sydney, and then especially when it's cold, the area like get a bit like painful. So yeah, so today like I just felt a bit better, and I was like, you know, let's just film a video because I don't have to stand up or anything. So yeah, it's a long overdue video that I wanted to do. I've ordered some of these random, you know, products that I wanted to try with you guys. So without further ado, let's get into it. So basically, like I found all of these products in this one particular website that I recently been shopping. It's like it's Australian based, but then like the website only carries like Asian, you know, beauty products, cosmetics, you know, everything like that. They even have like Japanese or Korean snacks like that, I think. I'm not sure, but yeah, like they also have like clothing, accessories, and all that stuff. This website is called Yes Style, and actually like a friend of mine suggested me because I only use Korean and Japanese skincare products, so I always order from them because it's like it's kind of hard to find Korean and Japanese skincare products around in the city. So so I just order it through the site, and the delivery is really fast. So while I was ordering like skincare products for myself, like I came across like some of the products that's in front of me. I just thought like it's cool, and so I just wanted to try and test out with you guys to see if it's just like, you know, gimmick or it's just like real deal. So in front of me you'll see some of these random cosmetics, makeup products, stuff like that on this table. Hi. So where do I start? Let's start with the biggest one or something. So this one is from Lively Cosmetics. This is basically the makeup sponge holder. I've been finding like what to store for my makeup blenders to be like really clean and hygienic, you know, all that stuff. So I came across this, and this is so cute. Look at this. So basically you just put like, you just put your beauty, this is really dirty, I just used it. Basically you just store your beauty blender in here. Look at this, so cute. It'll be cuter if I clean my sponge. But yeah, so this is the makeup sponge holder. So you just like put it on the vanity or something. But I have this one. I put my beauty blenders in here like this, and then just like close it with the lid so that like no like dust or anything can like, you know, go in there. But yeah, I think this will be really useful too. Okay, I'll rate this makeup sponge holder thing like 9 out of 10. Second one is this one. Can you guys see these? Okay, so this one is from the brand Berrysome, and this is basically what I needed. So when I first saw this product, I was like, are you sure? Like, is this just a mimic? But honestly, I've tried this like a couple of times already to just like, you know, test it out if it really works or it's just like, you know, but it actually works. Okay, I'm sorry, I haven't even tell you what this is. So this is called Styling Hair Setting Cara. So Cara as in like mascara. It looks like a mascara. It has like plastic bristles like a mascara. The wand looks kind of like mascara wand. This is actually used on your hair. So my hair is like originally curly, and at school, like when we're doing like practical, like we always have to tie our hair back and then like make a bun or whatsoever. So I always end up like having like baby, you know, baby hair sticking out like all over. Like it looks even like a headband because like there's all like curly, you know, baby hair sticking out. So what this does is like, this is the one. The product is like clear, so like you basically like brush it off. Like, okay, for example, this part, as you can see, you can just like brush it off, and then it will stick to the other part of the hair. So that's what it does for this part. Like, I really like it, and I think it really helps me. I just throw this in my, you know, school bag, and then like every time some of my baby hair like came out, like, I just like, you know, rub it in. A friend of mine was like, "What are you doing with your mascara?" And then I was like, "No, that's not a mascara. It's just hair setting cara thing." I think it's a real deal. And but the thing is, like, it doesn't last like, you know, when you apply like spray just to make your hair like, you know, stay in place for like, you know, the whole day or the whole event that you're going, your hair actually stays. But with this, I think it helps your hair for like good amount of time. I think it only lasts like a few hours or so, but I think it's good enough. As long as you can just bring this, you can just throw this in your purse or just carry it around, it's fine. I'll give this product 7.5 out of 10 because it does what it says, and yeah, it's a useful little product. Okay, so this is also from the brand Berrysome. I think most of you guys have already seen this product or not. This is peeling lip tint. So basically after you apply it, like, and then you have to wait for it to dry up, and then when you peel it off, like, you have like a natural looking like red lips. So let's try it. This is in the color Sexy Red. It smells kind of weird, some kind of like cheap perfume. Wait, before I do anything, I need to read the instruction. Okay, so what it, wait, it's all written in Korean. Huh? There's no instruction. Okay, so I'm just gonna just guess, and I'm not gonna like do any further research for this. So this is all written in Korean, and I saw a number. There's like 5 to 10, and so I'm assuming I can leave this on for like 10 minutes. Oh, there you go. Hi. The texture is a bit like a jelly. It's a bit sticky. Okay, so the texture is like so sticky, and it's really hard to like move around. So look at my lips. Doesn't look good, but yeah. Let me just apply more. Okay, I think that's enough. Okay, it's really sticky. Now you set the time to 10 minutes. Set it. And let's wait. It's like when you dye your hair, you know, like you leave it on for a while, and then when you wash it off, like, you have this hair color, and this is kind of a similar concept too. And then when you peel it off, like, you'll have like, you know, natural looking pinkish red lip color. So, but let's see whether if it's just a lie or if it's a real deal. It's really hard to talk with this. Okay, so I'll be back in 10 minutes. Done. Okay, I'll zoom you guys in to see. So it's all dried up here. Let's also take out this residue. So this is the result, and I really like this color, and it looks really natural on your lips. But the thing is, this is not the residue of it. When I first applied, it was like not hydrated well. It wasn't exfoliated well, so it was just like my skin. And another thing is, you know, from the beginning I said it smells like a cheap perfume, like flowery kind of scent. Even after you know, take off the product, you can still like taste that scent. So if you don't like it, then I don't think you will like it. But other than that, I really like it, and I think the product did what it says. It's a cool product to try with your, you know, your girlfriend in sleepovers and stuff like that. It's fun and cool. Okay, so I will rate this product 6 out of 10. Okay, so I also got some razor for my brows. I just wanted to like, you know, shape a bit if I want to. And this is also from the brand called Lifly. Okay, and then another product is this one. So this is called Nail Art Transfer Foil. This looks really cheap, and it is kind of cheap. And this basically is like it's like foil that you put on your nails. It's a new trend for nails, like holographic color like on some nails. Yeah, so that's what I wanted to try. How do you do this? Okay, so basically what you have to do is they didn't say anything on the package, but I don't know, let me just you know, wing it. Okay.
Oh, okay, so you just basically, wait, can I sit down? Yeah, that's not it.
Okay, so this is just a shitty stuff, I must say, because what they want you to do is like cut these little, you know, like, if, I don't know if you guys can see, but cut these little holographic shape thing in pieces, and then you have to just like stick it on your nails, like after you apply like gel nail or whatsoever. They just roll it up and put this wrapping paper in this little like cheap plastic container. Okay, I don't want to waste my time anymore. So I think this is such a fail, and I'm gonna rate this 0 out of 0 because it's such a gimmick and it doesn't look like what it's shown on their website. Okay, so let's try this one. This is V-Line China, not China, sorry. This is V-Line Chin Patch. So this patch helps you get like, you know, V-shaped thing. Mostly they did like surgery to get V-shaped, but like now you can buy these kind of, you know, products in the market. So let me read you some of their ingredient and what it really does. So it's a stretchable patch containing ingredients like collagen and centella asiatica, restore skin elasticity and glossy appearance, let cheek and chin tense, create perfect V-line face. Cool. Okay, let's read their direction. So first, remove the V-line chin patch from the package. Place the chin and then hook the top ear hooks onto ears. Relax and wait for 10 to 15 minutes. And then remove the patch and press excess products onto the skin. Use these twice a week to maximize their effect. Okay, so I only have one, so I don't think there will be much like difference, but yeah, let's just try it. Okay, sounds good. Smells good. You get my headband to just, you know, get my hair out of the way. Okay, let's do this. So it looks like this. I can feel there's a lot more products in here. There you go. So it looks like a mask that the most like Korean, you know, celebrities wear when they go out to public. Okay, I look ridiculous. I look like I had a surgery. Oops, one of my nail came off. Okay, so I'm gonna set the time to they said 10 to 15 minutes, so I'll just make it like 10 minutes. There you go. Okay, so I'll be back in 10 minutes. Okay, so my other nail came off too, and I don't know where it went. Oops, and the time is up. So I'm gonna take this off, and I know there won't be any difference because I only bought one patch and it doesn't work that way. The thing is, I love the way it felt on my chin when I was like waiting for the time to set. Okay, let me just take this off first. So when I was wearing the patch, I can feel the cool, you know, sensation, but it's not like stinging. It doesn't sting, but like I know that there is like a cool, you know, sensation. I think it will definitely work when I put this on for next 5 more minutes. So, you know, just one patch won't make any difference, but I think I wanted to try more because I kind of want like V shape. I have like double chin, so I just wanted to like stretch it out a bit. But I think overall the product looks promising. So I think I will just order a few more and then like try it. So I'll give this V-line chin patch like 7 out of 10 because it's gentle on your skin. Last but not least, I'm gonna also try out this lip product too. But this lip product is not like any other lip product in the market because there's like liquid, there's gloss, there's solid lipstick. But this is powder. So this is from the brand called Riri. I think it's how it's pronounced, but I'm not sure. It spells R-I-R-E. And it's from Riri and it's lip powder. So let's see what the fuss is about. I've seen this product for a while now, so let's just try this. So this is the Riri lip powder. So this is the wand. Look at this. This is legit powder. Look. This is legit powder. Over here, guys. And it's a lipstick. Let's try this out. I'm excited. So, you guys saw that, and I'm gonna try this now. Wait, let me zoom you guys in. Okay, just a disclaimer. I've had the, you know, lip tint under it, so just, but I will tell you guys the difference. Oh my god. So, it applies wet on my lip. Okay, let me just give you guys some swatches first. So this is the powder product, but it applies wet, like a lip tint. Oh my god, this is some sort of sorcery. Wow, and I love this color. So this one is in the color Fashion Red. The handle is a bit hard to hold, so I need to get a good grip. This is the color, and I think the texture itself, the product itself is like powder, but when I apply it on my lips, it feels wet and it feels like I'm just applying like, you know, liquid lip tint. But it looks opaque and it looks matte. It seems like as if I just apply like matte liquid lipstick. Oh my god, I'm digging this. Okay, so I will give this product 10 out of 10. I think it feels really nice. It doesn't feel sticky or like too dry on your lips. It feels hydrated. I really like this. So okay guys, so we have come to the end of the video and I've lost like 3 nails already. But I had so much fun trying all these products out. And if you guys want to know my skincare routine or what I use on my skin, please just leave a comment down below and I will give you guys my skincare routine video. So thank you so much for watching and I'll come up with more interesting videos for you guys. So please subscribe if you haven't already and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Bye.